okay guys, I'm going to demonstrate proper way to do a tire flip. And the reason that we do tire flips is because it's one of those unconventional lifts that has a huge carryover into your sport, because it's a compound movement. You're going to use every muscle in your body to do this lift. And it's tough to do if you've never done it before. You're going to wake up the next day, everything's going to be sore, but it's going to help you become a better athlete. So we're going to break it down like this. The first thing you want to do when you're doing a tire flip is to make sure that you get the most surface area on the tire, on the side of the tire, as you can. So you want to put as much area of your body up against that tire as you can. You don't want to just put it in your hands, because you're going to put too much weight on the bicep, okay? That's dangerous. The next most important step after focusing on surface area is foot placement. So I want you to make sure that your feet are properly behind that tire to be able to drive into this tire, and the idea is to drive it up and out. So it's sort of like a plane taking off from an airstrip, okay? So it's this type of motion is what you want to be focusing on. You don't want to pick it up and push it. You want to be all one smooth motion. And I'm going to demonstrate that. Okay guys, we're going to break this lift down so step by step. Every time I'm going to explain a lift, I'm going to break it down step by step. Everything from where your foot should be to where your head's going to want to be in this lift. So the first thing we're going to do is assess the tire that you're working with. We got about a 500 pound tire here with a decent tread size on it, so you're going to have a pretty good area to put your hands on the tire, all right? So first things first, put the tire down. And then what you're going to want to do is get down against it like so, with a lot, like I was saying earlier, with a lot of surface area on the tire. Don't pick the tire up like this with your feet up against it, because you'll end up having way too much pressure on the bicep, and you can tear a bicep doing that, and it's not the right way to train your posterior chain to get this lift going. So put as much surface area on the tire as you can. So you'll see that I got my neck into it, my shoulders into it, my arms into it. Try to find a tread down here you can put your hands on, okay? And then kick your butt up so your feet back. So like I was saying earlier, you want to drive this tire up and out, okay? So it's going to look like so. Feet back, surface area, head up. Tire flip. Okay, so I just showed you how one solid motion how to flip this tire. Now I'm going to break it down section by section for a proper tire flip. Showed you where you need to put your feet, showed you how much surface area you need to put on your shoulders. Those are the two most important parts. The other one is to make sure upon lift or takeoff that you don't stick your butt up in the air. That's not the way you want to do it. You want to keep the posterior chain, which again is your hamstrings, your glutes, and your low back engaged the whole time for the lift. So there's two ways to do this. You can use a knee to help the tire go over, or you can do it all in one lift. So I'm going to show you here with a knee. There's the knee. So that helps you transition from here to here, and then push over. The other way to do this is going to be all in one motion, okay? So this is a little harder to do, especially when the tire gets heavier. But all in one motion, it's going to look something like this. With every tire flip, make sure that when you get it up, when you get this tire flip up, you don't just stop here and kind of just let it float over, okay? I want you to come across with the tire with a lot of pressure. Slam it down every time. That's how you do a proper tire flip.